And once again, John Patrick Bedell is from Hollister. Action News reporter Ravi Kapoor continues our team coverage. He's live in Hollister right now, where federal investigators are searching the home. Good afternoon, Ravi.
Good afternoon, May. Well, right now we're just learning from San Bernardino Sheriff Curtis Hill that he has been in touch with the parents of John Patrick Bedell in recent days. Apparently, 2 months ago, his parents filed a missing persons report and were very concerned about him after he was pulled over in Texas for speeding. In January, John Patrick Bedell came back to California, did not want to inform his parents what his activities had been up to that point, and then took off once again and apparently headed off towards Washington. Now, Curtis Hill will be having a press conference at 12:30. We've just learned to describe what his take is on this whole situation. And from what the AP is reporting this afternoon, earlier Hill described the parents as telling him they were worried that he had purchased a gun. This was after his stop in Texas after he was pulled over by the highway patrol for speeding. So we'll have a lot of these more details as they come out this afternoon. Certainly, it shocked this whole community of Hollister. A lot of folks, including one of the San Benito County supervisors, who's very close with the family, say this is completely out of character, something that they could never imagine happening. May?
And, Ravi, we all know that Hollister is a very tight-knit community, and this is a developing story, and we are learning more about who John Bedell is. And as you said, sheriff's deputies speaking with his parents. And I don't know if you were aware of this, but they had said that Bedell had sort of been under radar from the police from a report that they had gathered. It was a police report saying that he was mentally unstable. Do you have any other idea of the state of Bedell, you know, in recent years?
Well, that's part of what the investigation is right now, one of the reasons why federal investigators are searching his parents' home and trying to figure out what led him to go off on these rants that you find on the internet and on YouTube, and what led him to drive cross country, apparently, to perpetrate this attack yesterday.
And, Ravi, what's the mood in Hollister? Have you gone into, you had mentioned the high school, have you gone into any stores? What's the mood like there for the community?
You know, we've touched base with some of the folks at San Bernardino High School, and a lot of the teachers who apparently were there during that era don't really remember him that well. Apparently, according to the principal that I spoke to this morning, he was only there for a couple of years and then ended up going to Gavilan College, so I guess potentially get a GED of some sort. So he only spent a couple of years at San Bernardino High School. The teachers that are still there don't really remember him. We are going to head over to the high school in just a little while to see if we can touch base and find out some more information. I understand he did spend at least 2 years there on campus, but, you know, he was kind of a nondescript student, and it happened, you know, he graduated. He didn't officially graduate from the school, but he's class of 91, so it's been about 20 years, and they don't have a whole lot of details for us.
All right. Thank you very much, Ravi Kapoor, reporting live for us in Hollister. And we should note that Bedell was a graduate of UCSC, getting a B.S. in physics. And now Ravi had mentioned about some videos that Bedell had posted. We are getting a closer look at a video posted by the username JPBedell2006, and this is on YouTube. In the video, Bedell, who worked in finance, gives a description on how currency is used in financial markets. You can watch the full video by going to our website, ksbw.com.